The Great Marsh has been a source of artistic inspiration since the 19th century and well into the 21st century. These are photographs by Les Bartlett. And a painting from the Celestial Image series by Gloucester artist Gordon Getterman. Two famous painters of the marsh that first come to mind are Arthur Wesley Dow and Martin Johnson Heade. Their iconic images are so romantic and transcendental in feeling. You can feel the expansive silences of the marsh in this painting by Martin Johnson Heade. Other artists of the Great Marsh that I love include Sandra Bellock Phippen, who lives not far from here in Wenham. Her work is full of light, whimsy, and joyfulness. And I'm drawn to the abstract, rich colours of Lauren Doucette's Great Marsh paintings. Lauren is one of my art teachers. There are also many photographers of the marsh who take their inspiration from the light, the sinuous lines of the marsh grasses, and the very American primeval feel of these lands. We see the work of Dorothy Monnelly here, and the photography of Stoney Stone, who, like Monnelly, lives in Ipswich, very close to the Great Marsh, which must be a constant source of artistic inspiration. I'm originally from the United Kingdom, from a county called Shropshire next to North Wales. As far as I remember, there are no marshlands there, but my early exposure to the rolling verdant hills and dales of Shropshire, here photographed by a childhood friend from Shrewsbury, Charles Crosland. And here are the old Tudor and Stuart houses. The Shropshire farm in Berwick, where I spent so many hours shaking the hazelnuts from the trees, laid the groundwork for my own inspiration from the Great Marsh. Memories of this Shropshire landscape, so different from the New England landscape that I now know and love, are deeply imprinted on my consciousness. In fact, I love my old childhood garden so much that I would pack a jam jar of the earth and bring it with me on the train to London at the age of 6. I am perhaps a unique combination of an environmental planner, landscape designer, as well as for the past 10 years a silk painter. The Great Marsh has long inspired me as an artist, but this inspiration comes also from my background of loving landscapes that form part of my daily life in both Shropshire, UK, London, and the North Shore. My work in landscape conservation with Ed Becker of Greenbelt set the scene for inspiration from American landscapes. In the 1980s, I travelled from London to Ithaca, New York, to study for a master's in city and regional planning at Cornell, and then moved to Boston, where I landed my first job in landscape conservation, working as director of Mass Highway's Open Space Program. Here I had the pleasure of working with Ed. Together we negotiated the purchase by the Highways Department of over 20 conservation easements along the edges of Route 128 from Exit 18 in Beverly to Exit 12 in Gloucester. From one inland highway corridor to another by the coast, the meandering Great Marsh Coastal Corridor first stirred my imagination as both an artist and as an environmental planner back in 2014 when I attended for the first time the Great Marsh Symposium. The topic was climate change, case studies and local adaptation. I'm drawn to weave together my planning and artist hats to protect vulnerable landscapes by painting on silk. My paintings illustrate the effects of climate change on the landscape of Essex County. I also collaborate on these banners with designer and photographer Leslie Bartlett, creating montages of silk paintings and photographs. The salt marsh areas of the Great Marsh have always intrigued me. I knew them to be very vulnerable to sea level rise, invasive phragmites and pepperweed, and that they needed undeveloped space to migrate. It occurred to me that there's very little public interpretation or education about the need we have to conserve and preserve our salt marshes. Perhaps, I wondered, I could fill that gap with both art and photography. So during the symposium, I conceived the idea of a series of beautiful and educational banners placed close to a salt marsh, showing the effects of climate change. I talked to my friends, Ed Becker of Greenbelt and Robert Buxbaum of Mass Audubon, and had the fortune to meet with Peter Phippen of the Great Marsh Coalition. We applied for a grant to create the artwork and banner installations and won an Essex Heritage Partnership grant. The four banners, together with signage illustrating both problems and solutions to climate change in the Great Marsh, were exhibited besides one of the most beautiful salt marshes in Essex County, on the Cox Reservation in Essex, at the Crane Estate Art Show, and at the Rough Meadows Nature Sanctuary in Rowley. The four banners, together with signage illustrating both problems and solutions to climate change in the Great Marsh, were exhibited in these beautiful areas. In 2016, Deborah Kramer, a very old friend and author of The Narrow Edge, A Tiny Bird, An Ancient Crab, and An Epic Journey, invited me to help put together an art exhibit to celebrate and explain her book visually. I was captivated by the coastal marsh areas that Deborah described, as well as the resilience and vulnerability of the horseshoe crab and the red knots, sandpipers weighing less than a coffee cup. Here are images from the show. Marshes have inspired artists from ancient times until now. I am only one of many far more illustrious painters to have been seduced by the natural beauty of marshes and worried about the consequences of developing on these fragile areas and the effects of climate change on these important resources. I think that artists have a special charge to capture the beauty and the threats to marshes. That is indeed part of my life's work, made even more poignant now as we've moved to a house in Annisquam where I daily watch and will put into new silk paintings the waters, skies and birds of the Annisquam River and surrounding marshes, which are indeed part of our Great Marsh.